Good morning, everyone, and thank you for joining us here on our virtual service on Facebook Live on this morning. We are so happy to have you, as well as those that are on the conference call as well. And as you know, of course, we had to go back virtual. We enjoyed being with you in the in-person services that we had for the few months, but because of the rising numbers of COVID-19 here in our area, we thought it was the best decision that everyone stay home and enjoy the service with us virtually. We want to make sure that you stay safe and healthy. And remember to continue to wear your mask and to stay social distance away to keep yourself safe and happy. And we just are so happy on this morning. Amen. A few days ago, we had a wonderful Thanksgiving, and I'm sure you enjoyed time spending with your family, whether that was in person or virtually, but you had that time to spend with your family. But above all, we thank God for God blessing us and giving us the things that we need, as well as we thank God again for me, it would be the gift of salvation. I am so grateful and thankful that God came into my life and saved me a number of years ago as a young girl, how that he saved my soul. And I thank God for the gift of salvation. Again, I even thank God even for our family spending time together during the Thanksgiving season. Praise God.
God bless you all. Thank you, First Lady. We thank God for you. And yes, we are welcome you into our Greater Holy Temple service. Thank you those on Facebook. Thank you those on conference call. Those that will watch us later on our website as well as YouTube. You have been a blessing to us, and we thank God for you. We are still here.
Yes.
We're not in person, but we are still here.
Yes.
Amen. God has blessed us with the technology to reach you, and we thank God for you. We hope and pray you had a wonderful Thanksgiving. Amen. Now, as we prepare to go into the service, into the praise and worship, into the Word of God, amen, that souls will be saved, sanctified, baptized, and filled with the precious gift of the Holy Ghost. And God is in the healing business. So enjoy this worship service with us. Amen. And let's have church.
Father, in the name of Jesus, Lord, we want to thank you once again for your love and kindness and your mercy that you bestowed upon us. Father, we want to thank you once again for another Thanksgiving weekend. And Father, you've been so good to us, Lord. And Father, we just want to thank you on today, Lord. And Father, we ask you right now, Lord, look down on our pastor and his companion, Lord. Look down on him and his family on today, Lord. Lord, we ask you to bless and strengthen him on today, Lord. And Father, give him the word to give to us on today, Lord. In the name of Jesus. And Father, we want to thank you how you watched over us last night while the death angel was out and about. Father, you kept your protected arms around us. And Father, you didn't let no harm or dangers come to us. And Father, you woke us up this morning. You woke us up in our right mind, Lord. You woke us up with a mind stayed on you, Lord. And because of that, we said thank you in the name of Jesus. And Father, we ask you to touch those in the hospital, Lord. Touch those at home on their sick bed, Lord. Lord, someone is calling on you on today, Lord. Lord, someone need a healing on today, Lord. And Father, we know you're able to do all things, Lord. We know you sat high and you look low, Lord, in the name of Jesus. And Father, we just glorify you on today, Lord. And Father, we uplift your name on today, Lord. And Lord, just your name by itself is worthy to be praised. And Father, we just thanking you right now, Lord, in the name of Jesus. And Father, we thank you how you kept us all week long, Lord. You kept us from all harm and danger, accident seen and unseen, Lord. And because of that, we got the right to say thank you. Thank you, Lord, in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. And Father, we just thanking you right now, Lord, for all that you've done and all that you're getting ready to do in the name of Jesus. And Father, we invite you in on today, Lord, just to have your way, Lord. Have your way on today, Lord, in the name of Jesus. And Father, bless the preached word on today, Lord. And Lord, let your word go out on today, Lord. Let your word reach someone on today, Lord. Let your word save someone on today, Lord. Let your word deliver on today. today, Lord, in the name of Jesus. And Father, send down your latter rain, Lord. Send down your rain, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Their power in your rain, Lord. Their deliverance in your rain, Lord. Their healing in your rain, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Their saving in your rain, Lord. And Father, in the name of Jesus, Father. And Father, look down on that mother, that father, that brother, that sister, Lord. And Father, look down on our loved ones on today. Look down on us, save one on today, Lord, in the name of Jesus, Lord. And Father, we ask you to save them, Lord. Save them right now, Lord, in the name of Jesus. And Father, we ask you to look down on our children, Lord. Look down on our grandchildren, Lord, in the name of Jesus, Lord. And Lord, we ask you, wherever they're at, Lord, we ask you to touch their mind, touch their heart, Lord. And Father, we ask you to save them, Lord, in the name of Jesus. And Father, we ask you to look down on our government on today, Lord. Look down on our president, Lord, in the name of Jesus, Lord. And Father, we just thank you right now, Lord, in the name of Jesus. And Father, we come out to give you the high praise on today. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, thank you, Lord. Thank you in the name of Jesus. Oh, glory, glory, glory. And Father, we invite you in on today, Lord, just to have your way, Lord. Have your way on today, Lord. Have your way right now, Lord, in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. And Father, we ask you to touch that alcoholic out there, Lord. Touch that drug abuser, Lord, in the name of Jesus, Lord. Deliver them right now, Lord, in the name of Jesus, Lord. And Father, we just thank you, Lord, for all that you've done and all that you're getting ready to do in the name of Jesus. And Father, it's just been another day, just another day that you have kept us, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Nothing that we've done so outstanding that you had to wake us up this morning. But by your grace, Lord, you've done it. And Lord, we just thanking you right now, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Oh, thank you, thank you, thank you. Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah, in the name of Jesus. Oh, I'm thanking you right now, Lord. Oh, I feel good in my sanctified soul on today, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Oh, we thank you right now, Lord. And Father, look down on Greater Holy Temple on today, Lord. Lord, we ask you to touch each and every last one of the members, Lord, in the name of Jesus, Lord. Someone is sick right now, Lord. And Lord, someone needs a healing right now, Lord, in the name of Jesus, Lord. And Father, we just touch and agree right now that it shall be done. And Satan be binding you up in the name of Jesus. Oh, the blood of Jesus cover right now. The blood of Jesus cover right now. Oh, we got victory on today. We got victory right now in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Oh, Lord, we're going to hold on. We're going to hold on to your unchanging hand, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Father, we walk by faith and not by sight.
To me, saints, I feel like giving God the glory. Oh, yes, all the glory, all the glory. I feel like giving God the glory. He's been so good to me. Put your hands together. Glory to God. So good, so good, so good, so good, so good, so good. He has been so good to me. Hallelujah. 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 Woo. I love the Lord, and I won't take it back. I love the Lord, and I won't take it back. I love the Lord. Cute. school. I like the new song, but I like the old ones too. So I kind of thought about one of the songs they used to sing when I first got saved. We don't hardly sing it no more. But I feel like this morning singing it, because how many know this is warfare? How many know we on the front line? I don't know how many on the front lines today, but listen, this is warfare. Yes, I'm a soldier. I'm a soldier. I'm a soldier. I'm a soldier. Y'all better sing. I'm a soldier. I'm a soldier. I'm a sanctified 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 soldier. If I die, let me die. Woo! If I die, let me die. If I die, let me die. If I die, let me die. What the soldiers do. You know, the soldiers get information and they get a march going. Come on. They pick them up and put them down. Left, right, left. Left, right, left. Left, right, left. Come on, get your march on. Yes, Lord, get your march on. Yes, Lord, get your march on. The soldiers put your feet together and they have a little chant they do. Come on. Yay! Come on, y'all got your march going? Up, two, three, four. Got my sword and got my sword. Up, two, three, four. Got my shield and got my sword. Up, two, three, four. Got my shield and got my... Come on, soldier. Up, two, three, four. Got my shield and got my sword. Up, two, three, four. Got my shield and got my sword.
God bless you. Thank you, praise and worship team. Amen. Thank God for the music ministry. And we give honor today to all whom honor is due, to my lovely wife, First Lady Ross, and to our church mothers. Amen. Mother Cain, to our district missionaries, to all the missionaries, all the elders and ministers and brothers and sisters that we have here. Thank God for our friends and family on Facebook. Facebook. God bless you. Those that are listening on conference call, amen. Welcome, welcome once again to Greater Holy Temple Church of God in Christ in the city of South Bend. Amen. I love this grand old church, and I love you. I hope and pray. This is the fifth Sunday in November, and I hope and pray that you had a wonderful Thanksgiving that just passed. We just enjoyed our Thanksgiving, just our immediate family. Amen. Laughing and joking and just fellowshipping with one another. We hope that you had that opportunity as well. I know some went on Zoom and did that, and we thank God just for family on today. I thank God for this wonderful Thanksgiving season, the opportunity to be able to thank the Lord for all that he has done for us. I also want to take time out and thank Greater Holy Temple family. We had a wonderful outreach this past Monday on the 23rd, and we had a wonderful outreach. We served the River Bend Cancer Society right here in South Bend, Indiana. We served the cancer patients. We had a hot meal ready to go for them. We did a drive-through, and so many showed up. We had an opportunity to talk with them. We did post that on Facebook Live. Hope you had an opportunity to see it. We just had a great time serving River Bend, serving our community. We even had one that came that what had nothing to do with River Bend. We were able to serve that family of four. And so we thank God for the opportunity to serve and to outreach to someone else. And we thank God for it. Thank God for that opportunity. Listen, we're going to go right to the word. I want you to hit that share button. Begin to share this word, share this service, share this message. Amen. Because we know we're going to have a great time in the Lord. Let us have a word of prayer. Father God, in the name of Jesus, we thank you and we praise you for the service of the Lord thus far. Thank you for everything that's said, everything that was done. And Lord, we ask that you bless the word of God as it goes forth, out over Facebook, as it goes over the conference line, as it goes onto YouTube later, onto our website. Lord, that it reach somebody's heart, that someone would be saved, someone would be filled with the gift of the Holy Ghost, someone would be healed, delivered, and set free. Now, Lord, let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in your sight. You are my strength, and you are my redeemer. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. You can say amen. Amen. God bless you. Listen, we're going to go right to the word of God on this morning. Going to turn your attention to the book of Genesis, the fourth chapter, Genesis chapter number four. Amen. I hope you have your Bibles at home. Amen. I miss seeing you all here at Greater Holy Temple, but amen, for our safety. Amen. We don't want to be, we want to get ahead of the game. We don't want to be behind. But for our safety, for your safety, amen, we chose to go back to virtual. We'll be together one more time filling these seats. Genesis, the fourth chapter. And I'm going to read just two verses in your hearing, and then we'll elaborate a little bit more. Genesis 4 and 8. Genesis 4 and 8. The word of the Lord says, "And Cain talked with Abel, his brother. And it came to pass, when they were in the field, that Cain rose against Abel, his brother, and slew him. And the Lord said unto Cain, Where is Abel, thy brother? And he said, I know not. Am I my brother's keeper? Am I my brother's keeper?" And I love to use for a thought on this morning, keeper or killer? Are you a keeper or a killer? That's the question on today. Let us define the keeper. Let us define the keeper. The keeper is a person whose job is to guard or to take care of something or someone. A keeper is a protector, a gamekeeper, a custodian, someone who is entrusting, you entrusting, that is there to protect you. A killer is a person or a thing that kills, something like a murderer, a slaughterer, a destroyer, a liquidator,
a exterminator, or even a terminator. And let me tell you, there is something that wants to terminate you, and that is the devil. That is Satan himself. He wants to kill, steal, and to destroy. Did you not know? Did you not know? I want to give you this one fact, that in 2019, 2020 is not over with yet, but in 2019, there were 16,425 murders right in the United States alone. That is 7 murders every hour. That would mean before the end of this service, there in this country, there will be 7 murders. Are you a keeper or are you a killer? Amen. Listen, we as Christians, we as saved and sanctified, filled with the Holy Ghost, Christians are to be keepers of other Christians. Yes, in two ways. First, we are not to commit acts of violence against one another. Amen. We shouldn't be going around punching one another and hitting one another. No domestic violence. No police should be coming to our saved Christian home regarding domestic violence. Amen. This includes violence also with the tongue, also in the form of gossiping, quarreling, jealousy, outburst of anger, throwing stuff all over the place and breaking out windows and things like that, slander against our brother, arrogance, and even disorders, amen, or discord amongst the brothers. Second, as we as keepers, amen, of being our Christian brothers, second, we are to exhibit brotherly love toward our brother and toward our sisters in Christ with a tender heart and a humble mind. You'll find that in 1 Peter 3:8. Take our time to research that. In this way, we keep those whom Christ gave his life. Christ gave his life for us. And who are we to take somebody else's life? Whether that be, amen, actually manslaughter, or murdering them, or even those things that I have just named, the slander of our tongue, the gossiping against our brother. Let me read this. In 1 Thessalonians, this is the NIV version, 1 Thessalonians, the 5th chapter, the 12th through the 15th verse. Here is our responsibility. And we urge you, brethren, to recognize those who labor among you and are over you in the Lord and admonish you, and to esteem them very highly in love for their work's sake. Yes, we're talking about this part. It's talking about the leadership. Amen. Be at peace among yourselves. Now we exhort you, brethren, warn those who are unruly, comfort the faint-hearted, uphold the weak, be patient with all. Let me read that again. Be patient with all. See that no one renders evil for evil to anyone. That's not us. We are to turn the other cheek. Amen. Amen. We're not to return evil for evil, but always pursue what is good, both for yourselves and for all. We have a responsibility, and that responsibility is to keep our brother, to be a keeper of our brother and our sister. We have here in our scriptures, we have what is typically called a dysfunctional family. A dysfunctional family is a family in which conflict, misbehavior, and often child neglect or abuse on the part of individual parents occur continually, regularly, leading other families members to accommodate such actions. Children sometimes grow up in such families with the understanding that such an arrangement is normal. They believe that the abuse is normal. They believe, amen, that the physical abuse, the verbal abuse, the batteries, the assaults, the domestic violence, that's normal. And that every family is a dysfunctional family, just like their family. Here we see in this word, we'll understand that Adam and Eve, they sinned against God. Yes, they ate the forbidden fruit that the Lord said, you can do anything you want, basically, but do not eat of this tree. And they ate of that tree, dysfunctional. And not only that, the Lord came to Adam and asked him about it. I'm just paraphrasing. Adam said, it wasn't me, it was that woman that you gave me. Huh? Dysfunctional. Amen. But you understand that they were driven from the Garden of Eden. God didn't abandon them all totally, but he blessed them with children. The first being Cain and the second being Abel. Let's talk about that for a minute. Go back to Genesis, the fourth chapter, starting at the first verse. You'll understand that the word of the Lord says in the King James Version that Adam knew Eve, his wife. First of all, they were married. They were husband and wife. Amen. They were male and female that had God had joined together, brought, amen, Eve from Adam's rib. Amen. And they were husband and wife. And it says that Adam knew his wife, and she conceived and bare Cain, and said, I have gotten a man from the Lord. So Cain was first. And then we understand the next verse says, and she again bare his brother. They were blood brothers. And that was Abel. And Abel was a keeper of the sheep, and Cain was a tiller of the ground. In other words, the older brother, he was more of a farmer of the corn and the wheat and the fruit and the vegetables and things like that, whereas Abel was more of a herdsman. He was more of a cattlesman. He was dealing with cows and dealing with sheep and dealing with goats and dealing with pigs and things like that, and chicken, where his brother was out in the field dealing with the corn and the wheat and so forth and so on. And in the process of time, verse number 3, in the process of time, it came to pass that Cain brought forth of the fruit of the ground an offering unto the Lord. So somewhere down the line, somewhere in the span of time, they were taught to give sacrifices unto the Lord. Amen. To give unto the Lord. How God has blessed them, amen, to give their portion back to the Lord. And Cain brought forth the fruit of the ground, whether that be the corn, whether that be the wheat, whatever the fruit of the ground was, that's what Cain brought. And Abel, who is his brother, he also brought the first things of his flock. Whatever that flock was it cattle, was it sheep, was it goat, whatever it was, amen, and the fat thereof, whether that was the fat from the pig or whatever. And the Lord had respect unto Abel and to his offering, because we believe, we understand that Abel gave his best. When Abel brought forth his first, when he brought forth his pig, or when he brought forth, amen, his cow, when he brought forth his lamb to be slaughtered or what have you, to be offered unto the Lord, Abel gave his best. How much more should we give our best unto the Lord? Our number one, amen. When it comes to our tithes and our offering, we give our best. We give our first. We give unto the Lord. Abel was doing that, and the Lord respected what Abel had given him, amen, unto the Lord. But Cain was another story. It says, but unto Cain, to his offering, he had no respect. The Lord didn't respect. Somehow down the line, Cain was not doing his best. Cain was not doing what he was supposed to be doing. He did do his corn and his wheat and whatever he grew that came from the ground, but was it his best? Apparently it must not have been his best, because, amen, the Lord did not respect that. And Cain, the Bible says, was very wroth. Cain, the Lord says, was very angry, and his countenance fell. Amen. He would go around moping or carrying on or being angry and upset, maybe kicking dirt. I don't know what all was happening, but his countenance had failed. Whereas Abel, amen, his countenance had to be up. His countenance had to be good, because the Lord respected and received his offering and received his sacrifice. But here we find in the word of the Lord came unto Cain and said, why art thou wrought? In other words, why you angry? What's going on, man? I give both of you all an opportunity to give unto the Lord, to make a sacrifice unto the Lord. Why are you wrought? And why is thy countenance fallen? Why are you going around here moping? If thou doest well, somebody say, if you do well, if you do good, if you do what you're supposed to do for the Lord asks you to do this. If you do what God will tell you to do, if you do well, thou should not be accepted. Come on, if you do well, the Lord accept it. Amen. We are stewards. Whatever God give us, whatever God lends to us, amen, we are should be good stewards over that. And if you do well, the Lord will respect it. Amen. And it came to pass. I'm sorry, let me go back up to 7. And if thou doest well, sin lieth at the door, and unto thee shall be his desire, and thou shalt rule over him. So listen here. If you don't do what you do, what you're supposed to do, the word of the Lord is saying, sin will be at the door. Amen. Sin will come knocking. Sin will come knocking. Will come bringing you down. Amen. Will come bringing you to your knee. The devil is like a roaring lion going to and fro, seeking whom he may devour. He's right at the door just waiting for you to sin, waiting to put his paw on you, waiting to put, amen, you into shackles one more time, waiting to put you in bondage one more time. Sin is at the door, but you have to do well before the Lord. You have to do well, and the Lord will respect you. Here it says, and Cain talked with Abel, his brother, his blood brother, right from his mom, amen, the same blood. And Cain had a little talk with Abel. Apparently, this was not a good talk. Apparently, this talk did not go well. And it came to pass when they were in the field that Cain rose up against Abel. I'm paraphrasing. He rose up against, in other words, he attacked him. It didn't say Abel attacked Cain, but Cain attacked him. Cain being jealous, Cain being angry, Cain being upset because the Lord received Abel's sacrifice and received Abel's offering and received respect from the Lord. Cain got jealous and Cain got upset and Cain attacked his brothers. Are you a keeper or are you a killer? Attacking your brother makes you a killer. And the Bible says, and it came to pass that they were in the field, and Cain rose up against Abel, his brother, and slew him, killed him. And the Lord said unto Cain, where is thy brother? You know, where is Abel? Now, the Lord already knew where Abel was. The Lord already knew what was going on with Abel. He already knew the whole situation between Cain and Abel. And he says here, Abel, where's your brother Abel? He said, I know not. Dysfunctional. You lying to the Lord. You lying to yourself, one, because you know where your brother is. You know you just slew him. And then you're going to lie to the Lord. You lie to God and say, am I my brother's keeper? The answer is yes. We are our brother's keepers. We are our brother's keeper. We have to do everything that we can to keep our brother, to love our brother, to take care of our brother. We have responsibilities to one another. We have a responsibility to one another. I'm going to slow down because I want you to get this. Amen. I want you to get this. We are to love one another. That's our responsibility. It is ordered. It is commanded by Jesus Christ in John 13 chapter, as taught by Paul to love in Romans 13 and 8, as instructed by Peter in 1 Peter 1 and 22, as stressed by John in 1 John 3 and 11. We are to love one another. Are you a keeper or a killer? We are to show our love to one another. How are you supposed to show love, Pastor? How are you supposed to do that? We are to receive one another. We are to edify one another. We are to serve one another. Not only that, we are to bear one another's burden. Let me slow down. Galatians 6, 1 and 2. We are to bear one another's burdens. We are to forgive one another. We are to be submissive one to another. We are to exalt one another. We are to be considerate one to another. And we are to be hospitable one to another. And that will show the love that we have for our brother. We are our brother's keepers. I want to ask you some questions to evaluate your role as a keeper. Evaluate your role as your brother's keeper. I want to give you some thought here. Huh? When one becomes a brother, when one just comes into the fold, one just gets saved, gives his heart to the Lord, gives a heart to God, just come in off the street and say, Lord, forgive me. Lord, forgive me for all my sin. Do you receive them into the family of God, or do you ignore them? Huh? Are they connected with the family of God in the congregation? Or do they remain on the outside where they came from? If we do not even know their names, can we be sure that we are failing? You can be sure that you are failing as your brother's keeper. At least we could get their name. Do we edify them, or do we put stumbling blocks in their way? Huh? Do we bring them up? Do we thank God for them? Do we praise God and let them know you've done the best thing ever by giving your heart to the Lord? Or do we put stumbling blocks in the way? Huh? So they'll fall and go right back where they came from. You are your brother's keeper. As individuals, are we bodybuilders encouraging the members of the body? You want to be a bodybuilder. I'm not talking about weights. I'm not talking about barbells. But building the body up, encouraging the body. Or are we like a cancer, weakening the members of the body of Christ by our examples, by our words, there we go with that tongue again, by our attitudes like Cain, our behavior like Cain, or that's just how I am. Everybody know me, that's just how I am. Well, how you are is wrong. Amen. Or, amen, but we have to have the best example, the best attitude, the best behavior to continue to draw, amen, people unto Christ. Do we serve them, or do we expect them to serve us? Do we demonstrate hospitality to them by visiting, by talking, by praying with them that are in need? Oh, this next one going to blow your mind. When a brother is overtaken in a fault, because guess what? Ain't none of us perfect. Amen. We make faults. We have issues. And we go to the Lord, amen, for forgiveness. But when your brother is overtaking a fault, do you even consider them? Are we even aware of who they even are? Do they drift away and no one make an effort to even reach out to them? You are your brother's keeper. Are we willing to bear their burdens in Galatians 6, 1 and 2 so as to help them to overcome and to be stronger in the Lord, to help them to overcome this hurdle, help them to overcome this situation so to make, amen, all things to work the good to them that love the Lord and called according to his purpose? Do we help? Do we help? Or do we rather not be bothered? That's their problem. That's not my problem. Are we quick to forgive them when they repent? Fear of not being forgiven and accepted back into the family of God may keep someone from repenting and returning to the fold. Do we communicate a willingness to accept them with our arms wide open? Amen. And offering complete forgiveness Amen. But I'm here to tell you, I'm getting ready to wrap this thing up. I'm here to tell you, I feel good down in my soul because I know that greater holy temple, you are a keeper, not a killer. Be a keeper, not a killer. But if we find ourselves in this predicament and we think we answered the question wrong, our behavior, our attitude, we have something to do. If you want to be your brother's keeper and you have failed, you need to repent because of a lack of concern. Repent because of your inactivities. Repent from whatever hinders us. Confess our shortcomings to the Lord and go quickly and resolve that thing because you are your brother's keeper. You are your sister's keeper. You are a keeper, not a killer. Say yes. Say yes. I want to be a keeper. I want to be a protector. I want to be a lover of my brother. I want to care for them. I want to accept them. I want to lead them to Christ. I do not want to kill them, but I want to rescue. I'm going to rescue 911. You better do it now while the blood, somebody say the blood, is running warm in your veins. Come on and praise him on Facebook. Come on, praise him on the conference line. You are a keeper. And what a keeper does is lead people to Christ. They protect them. They help them. They lead them. They guide them. Yes. They want them to be saved. Say yes. God bless you. Amen. We praise God. Keeper or killer? You want to be a keeper. Amen. You want to be a keeper. Love your brother. Take care of your brother. Amen. And amen. Do whatever you can to lead them to Christ, to make them stronger. I talked about being a bodybuilder. A bodybuilder takes prayer for your brother. A bodybuilder takes fasting for your brother. A bodybuilder takes a simple phone call to your brother. Bodybuilding is a simple text to your brother. How are you doing? How can I help you? Let us pray together. Let us fast together. You are a bodybuilder. And during this time, during this COVID-19, what better time to be a bodybuilder? What better opportunity to be a keeper, to make a phone call, to follow up, to say we love you. Hang on in there. It's going to be all right. Come on, give God some praise. Give him some glory. And we thank God. Amen. Let us pray. Father God, in the name of Jesus, we thank you on today. We thank you for your word. I've given your people what you have given me. And Lord, we ask that you're blessed right now. Lord, if someone has not been her keeper, that they would repent, that they would confess, and they would resolve to get it right. In the name of Jesus, we love one another. We are our brother's keeper. I thank you, O God, for the word of God. I thank you, O God, for the souls that are listening. And if there's someone that's on Facebook, there's someone on the conference line that is saying, you know what? I need to get it right. Get it right with God first. Go to God. Let's do it. Let's tell the Lord, Lord, I'm sorry. I'm sorry for everything I've done. I repent. Yeah, I'm sorry, but I also repent because I do not want to do it again. I mean in my heart, accept the Lord as your Savior. Accept him as your Lord and Savior. Tell him, Lord, forgive me right now. I repent right now. Forgive me of all my sins, all my shortcomings. Come into my heart. Lord, come into my heart. Save me. Forgive me. In the name of Jesus, I believe that you died on the cross. I believe that you shed your blood for the remission of my sin. Save me, Lord. I want you to be my Savior. In Jesus' name, amen. And if you said that prayer, we believe that you're saved. You mean it down on high. We want to hear from you. Amen. Go to our website, mygstchurch.com, and drop us a line. Say, I gave my heart to the Lord the Sunday right after Thanksgiving. Amen. And let us be your keeper. Let us be your bodybuilder. Let us talk with you. Let us pray with you. In Jesus' name, we thank God. Come on, Facebook, give God a hand. Give God a praise on today. We love you, and we thank God for you. I thank God. Listen, we're getting ready to go into our ministry of giving, and we thank God. Amen for each of you. So I'm going to say amen. We're going to say amen for our deacons that they would come and receive our ministry giving. And stay with us. I have a special announcement, a special thank you that's coming up. Amen. After the deacons, stay with us. God bless you. I love you. And we have great expectations.
We thank the Lord for that wonderful message on the day. Are you a keeper or a killer? Of course, we all want to be keepers. I'm here today to receive an offering. Today is our fifth Sunday. It's our pastor's aid Sunday. This offering aids the pastor and his outreach and his ministry. Of course, pastors have to do a lot of traveling at times. Well, maybe not so much now, but you can understand what I'm saying. It aids the pastor in doing the things that pastors have to do. Of course, unless you ever been a pastor, you wouldn't know what I mean, but I'm quite sure that he does and he appreciates it. On Pastor's Aid Sunday, we are asked for $25. All those that can, we'd be more than happy. And those that can't, pray to the Lord that he would bless you so that the offerings that you ask for, that you'll be able to give. And I just sincerely believe, I believe it in my heart with everything in me, that if you ask God to do it, he'll do it. He did it for me. He's no respecter of persons. I'm sure that he'll do it for you. Now I say a word of prayer. Father God, in the name of Jesus, Lord, we ask you, bless this offer we're about to receive. Lord, we ask you to bless those that have on today, and even bless those more that have not, next time that they may have to give. And Father, bless our pastor. Even bless those aides that help him out in this department, oh God. And Lord, we're going to ask this in your son, Jesus' mighty name, and we thank God. Amen.
God bless you. Thank you, Deacon Kane, for that ministry of giving. Thank you all that have and will donate to the Pastor's Aid Department. What a great auxiliary as they aid me. I thank God for them. Thank God for you at Great Old Temple. Listen, I failed to make mention of our Thanksgiving morning prayer. We had prayer on the line, on the conference call line, and we thank God for the prayers and, amen, the testimonies, the word of God. God bless you. Amen. What a way to kick off Thanksgiving, and we thank God we were able to do that and kick off Thanksgiving with an early morning 7 a.m. prayer. God bless you. Thank you. Listen, I told you I had a special announcement. I wanted to thank God. Many of you have already started getting your popcorn, that have gotten their popcorn for Thanksgiving this past Thursday. I hope you enjoyed it. The popcorn sale will go from now, obviously, all the way until December 15th. So you have an opportunity to grab some of that delicious popcorn, just like we did. Enjoy that delicious popcorn. Amen. And help Great Old Temple out. This is where it's going as well. This is our Greater Holy Temple Christmas board. We call it My Christmas Gift to Greater Holy Temple. And thank God, we're going to be giving gifts to our loved ones, to our children, to our grandchildren, and what have you. What better way also to give a Christmas gift to Greater Holy Temple? And we asked all of our Greater Holy Temple members to sow a seed of $30. Amen. And then to share the popcorn sale. And the popcorn sales will also go toward the board. As you can see on the board, we've already had people turn in their envelopes, their Greater Holy Temple Christmas envelopes. Some of those envelopes are in memory of various ones, and we have that as well. But we're on the way. Amen. We reached our first little plateau of $400, and we're over that. And we thank God for those that are already given. Thank you so very much. Support our Greater Holy Temple Christmas board. Amen. And be a blessing to Greater Holy Temple. I love you.
God bless you, saint. I hope and pray that you enjoyed the word of God.
Yes.
You enjoyed the whole service. Amen. Are you a keeper or a killer?
All right.
I'm hoping and praying that you are a keeper. We are our brother's keepers. Amen.
Yes.
Share that with somebody. Share that word with somebody.
Yes.
And I hope you were blessed on today.
Yes, and I know that my soul was blessed on this morning as well, and we just want you just to think about the words that were preached on today and let that carry you throughout the whole week. Continue to join us on our Facebook on our Tuesday nights as well as our Thursday nights as well. You can see us on Facebook at least 3 times during the week. We want to make sure that word of God is getting out to those that need it, because our souls need to be fed. And so we just praise God again for you joining us on today. And we have
great expectations.